clients because house painters use it to seal knots on wood before painting.
Is French polish a wood?
Shellac.
It's
just traditional shellac. Mm-hmm. I don't think it's still making it, but traditionally it was the excretion of a beetle from Indonesia. But quite, and you can really pack a lot of pigment in. You don't want to really don't really, you really want it's quite a paint, so one stroke is enough.
And you don't wear anything else, just
shellac and spirit. Mm-hmm. You need liquid spirits to wash and brush, which is why this is good. So do this carefully. I prefer to hold it like that so I can see where I'm going. You see it covers really nicely, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And then so just cover first and then go this way. So you don't, if you don't be careful, you can block, if you go like that again, you put rear over the top. So sit down. So try to go parallel like that. And stiffer brush is better. If you get too floppy one, it might bend over the top. Gold, and you want to put a red line around the gold, I tend to use this because being tempera with your plata isn't really robust enough from gold to be handled. It's not like permission, but if you pick it up, it's going to bump it off really quickly. So I tend to use shellac with red for red lines on gold. It's more robust.
So what's the recipe for that?
Shellac and red ochre.
But you got spirits here.
That's to wash the brush.
Oh.
That's the solvent for
Right.
That's the solvent. Because I've sealed this already with the the virus from Fitzpatrick, that's better than I use another. So then when this is dried, probably after 2 hours, mm-hmm. I give a whole lot of another coat of wood varnish and that seals it off.
Mm-hmm.
It also, that wood varnish helps to stabilise the wood. So if, let's just say, it's hanging against the damp wall, you're going to get a lot of dampness coming to one side, not the other, so you might have a bit of warping. But the varnish sort of stabilises the wood, giving a differentiation between moisture one side and the other.